गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द नेक्स्ट सेट ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द लूपिंग रिलेटेड प्रोग्राम्स फॉर व्हाइल लूप, फॉर लूप, राइट? सो दैट सो वी रिवाइज्ड ऑल द प्रोग्राम्स रिगार्डिंग लूपिंग. ओके, एंड देन वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड वन प्रोग्राम टू फाइंड द रिवर्स, right? So wherein we have reverse of a number and then we are comparing the original number with its reverse. Okay, so like every class the chat option is enabled, and you can send in your doubts if you have any through chat, or you can unmute yourself and also ask your doubts. Okay, so here we have the program displayed wherein problem 19 we discussed in the last class. So we also have seen the tracing for one example, right? 1 2 3 4 we took. So in case that 1 2 3 4 is the pin number, we have to find the reverse and then check if 1 2 3 4 and its reverse are equal. If it is equal, we print a message, right? So here there are two parts. The first thing is take input for pin number and then store that to a original number, and when pin is not equal to 0, we find the reverse, right? So this we discussed with the tracing. So this to find the reverse and then print it, this is the first part. So first we are finding reverse of a number. Next we are checking compare reverse with original to see if they are equal. So second part is to compare the number with its reverse. So if it is equal, then no alarm is sent, because and Mr. Varun is in trouble, so that we will print. Or else if reverse is different, 1 2 3 4 and its reverse 4 3 2 1 are different, so this if condition becomes false, so alarm is sent, police will come and take action, right? So this problem we discussed along with a tracing for an example, and I had asked you to solve for 1 2 2 1. I hope you were able to solve it. Now if you had any doubts, please let me know. Were you able to trace for 1 2 2 1?
It was,
Meghana. Meghana, yes,
yes ma'am.
Okay, you were able to trace it fine.
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so others, I hope there was no problem. We discussed in detail, right? So in this case, we'll move forward then with the next problem, that is problem 20. Okay, so problem 20 is for Taylor series. I think this name may be familiar to you all. In mathematics, you may have studied about Taylor series, which is used to find the value of sine x, the trigonometric operation sine x, right? So in this case, we are taking first x has to be in terms of radian. Okay, for this, if we take input in terms of degrees, we have to convert it to radian first and then find the value of sine x. So let us see the question first. We will analyze the question and understand what is the question all about. So here Mr. Umar is very much interested to know how calculator will give for the result for trigonometric function. After research, he knows the mathematical concept. So he wants to try with respect to sine x. Okay, so sine x, and with the help of faculty, he solves Taylor series. Okay, so Taylor series helps to get the answer of sine x. Okay, now what is this Taylor series? So as we can see, so we know Taylor series, sine x is equal to x minus x cube by 3 factorial plus x power 5 by 5 factorial minus x power 7 by 7 factorial, and it continues. Okay, so help Mr. Umar to program the same. So here we know by the question that we have to find sine x value, given the value of x, using the Taylor series. Okay, now the Taylor series is also given. It may or may not be given. Please note that you should know what is Taylor series. Okay, so sine x is equal to this given expression. So this is the Taylor series. Now using this expression, we know that we can find the value of sine x. So first, to find this, we have to analyze the expression, analyze the question thoroughly. So what is the input? input is x, okay, and then what is output? It is sin x. What is the logic to find sin x? So next, once we know what is input output in a program, we have to find the logic. Logic is using this expression, the Taylor series, we have to find. So now we know this much, the logic. Now how to solve for this logic is the next question. So how to solve it? So let us analyze. So first we have the value of x. Okay. So we have a series and we can see that there are some terms which are like similar. Okay. We have some numerator by denominator. Numerator is in the power of x power y. It is in the format of x power y. Say x cube, x power 5, x power 7 and so on. Denominator is in the power of factorial. So we have some common terms. Some common terms are added or subtracted. So that is what we observe. So what we can do here is we can find the terms separately and then add them or subtract them. Okay. So we are still analyzing how to solve this. So when we say observe the Taylor series, we have to see each term. Okay. Each term is in the particular format. Okay. If we say the first term, please compare this first term with second term. So first term is similar to x power 1 by 1 factorial, isn't it? X power 1 will be x divided by 1 factorial is 1. So we can write the first term also in the same format, x to the power of 1 divided by 1 factorial. So all the terms are in a similar format. So the same thing has to be evaluated. So when we are repeatedly evaluating or doing some task, we can use the concept of loop. Right, we have seen repeatedly we have to find this term itself. Only the numbers are changing, but the term format is the same. So let us see more about this. What is the other common factor? So when we observe x power 1, x power 3, x power 5, x power 7, next will be x power 9. So we observe that the power is odd number. Yes. So please observe every minute thing. So these things will help to write the logic. Okay. To write the logic for the program, we have to observe each and every minute thing. Okay. So here we found the power of x is an odd number. It starts from 1. Now let us see what happens to the denominator. So denominator here will be 1 factorial. Okay. That is 1 itself. Next we have 3 factorial. Next term we have 5 factorial. Then 7 factorial. And then we will have 9 factorial, 11 factorial and so on. It continues. What can we observe? So even this is odd number, right? Odd numbers factorial. So from 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on, 9, 11 and so on, right? So even the denominator is odd number and it's factorial. Okay. So now we observe so many things. We see that the terms are very much similar. We have to evaluate each term. And then are we adding everything? Let us check. So first we have x minus. So then are we subtracting everywhere? No. So next one is plus. Then we have minus. Then we have plus. So when we observe this, the plus and minus are alternating. Please be careful while doing this. If you simply write plus, we will get a wrong answer. So we have to observe these minute things. Minus, plus, minus, and plus. And this keeps on continuing, right? So minus, plus, that means each of the terms are with a negative sign first and then positive, then again negative. Alternately, we have the different signs. So how do we get alternate sign? So if we get a number, say for example 3, how do we make it minus? So when you multiply by minus 1, it becomes minus 3. Then again we multiply by minus 1, it becomes plus 3. Minus into minus is plus. So we know this format so that we can multiply each term by minus. So it changes the sign, right? So if we have 3, it becomes into minus 1, it becomes minus 3. Again into minus 1, it becomes plus 3. And this can be continued for each term. So then we can get alternate sign. I hope this is clear. So we analyze so many things about this problem, right? So once we analyze the question, next, we know that we have to first declare few things, right? So let us see, here is something new you can see. So this we have still not used. Okay. So please observe this. So here we have, I will just take this series. So in this case, observe some things. We have hash include, stdio is what we already know. We are including the header file, right? Hash include is a preprocessor directive. So we have used this in all the programs. So similarly, there are many more preprocessor directives. As and when we come across the examples, we will discuss, okay? So then we have one more preprocessor directive, which is called as hash define. Very important, please note, hash define is a preprocessor directive which helps us to give a value for a variable. Okay, so here hash define is a preprocessor directive which helps us to give a value for a variable. So let us see which variable, that is pi. Pi value we know is 3.141. So how do we define the value of pi? There is a particular syntax. So we write hash define, then we write space, then variable name, space, value. So once we write this, it means that the value 3.141 is getting assigned to pi. So once we write hash define pi 3.141, it is same as writing pi equal to 3.141. Now we may get a doubt that that same thing can be written inside, right? Why are we writing it here? Okay, so this is called as a global variable. It is written outside the main function. The usage of global variable can be appreciated in functions, right? We may have multiple functions, so we will discuss that also. Now, for now, you are being introduced to the concept of global variable. Global variable, if we write it outside the program, it can be used throughout the program, right? Outside the main function also. Do not worry much about it. Outside main, we have still not written anything, any program. That is using concept of functions we will discuss. Okay. So now we are defining a pi value. Wherever we define this pi we use, it means that it is going to get the value of 3.141. Now, why did we take pi? It is not there in Taylor series, but there is something more, right? So for this Taylor series, input x has to be in terms of radian, right? So we are going to take in terms of degree. So we are taking input in terms of degree. Now, to convert from degree to radian, there is a formula, right? What is that? The degree, if we give 30, how to convert to radian? 30 into pi divided by 180 will convert 30 degrees to radian. Okay, so that is the requirement. That is why we have defined pi. Okay, so let us see that next. So we have defined pi equal to 3.141. Next, we have int main. You can give void main also, no problem. Okay, so if you have any doubts, we just analyze the question. Please let me know. Okay, I hope the question is clear. So we will go forward with the program. Okay, so we analyze that question is x is the input and I mean in terms of radians. So then we have to find out sine x. Sine x has to be found using Taylor series. We saw Taylor series and we analyzed the meaning and what is the terms used in Taylor series. Now that same thing we have to use and write the program. Okay, so here we have defined hash define pi 3.141. This means we are giving the value of 3.141 to pi. So first we are declaring a few variables. Note that declaration we can add also later any variables if we require. So here we are declaring first I. So we cannot change the value of pi once it is defined, and we also know that it is a fixed value. If we define it once, if we are defining a equal to 5, we cannot change it in the program. Okay, so this is constant. We cannot change the value of pi. I hope your doubt is clear. Okay, so we'll continue. Yes, okay. So once we define we pi as 3.141, we cannot change the value of pi. And we also know that anyway, pi is a fixed value of 3.141. So we will not change it also. Okay, so we cannot change this value. Let us see, we are using some variables. So we know that this will continue, say, for many terms. So in this, based on the value of the number of terms also we are finding. Okay, so let us see the value, and then we are taking I. Okay, first we are declaring I. We want some variable for loop index. You may take any variable. This is just example variable. You can consider any variables here. Okay, so we have taken I for the loop index, and then n is the number of terms. Okay, and degree we are declaring float because it can be degree in terms of point something. Okay, so float, and that will be the input. Next, we have taken the variable x. X is in terms of radian. Whatever degree input we have, we will convert that to radian, and that will be stored in x. And then we have term. Why is this term? We see each term is defined. Okay, we have to calculate x power x cube by 3 factorial is one term. X power 5 by 5 factorial is one more term. X power 7 by 7 factorial is another term. Okay, so that is why we have taken term. And then we have taken one variable called sum. We are adding or subtracting the whole thing. The answer has to be stored somewhere every time. So for that sake, we have taken sum. Okay. So here, that is the required variables. If we require later also, we can declare any more. Okay. So that is not anything like fixed. So don't worry about initialization and declaration here. So we can declare if we use any more variables. So initially, sometimes we will not know what are the variables required. We can continue with the logic, and then in case we declare some more variables, if we use, we can declare it also. Okay. So first we are taking the input. So we have printf scanf that used to take the input. First we are taking input for the number of terms n, and then next input is the degree. Please take care. N is an integer. Format specifier is percentage d. Degree is float, format specifier percentage f. So I will not go in detail about printf and scanf syntax because we already know that. Okay, so we are taking input for number of terms and degree. Now we know that x has to be in radians. So next step is we will convert this degree into radian. How to convert? So we have the formula x is equal to whatever degree we have taken, say 30 or 45 or 90 or whatever degree we take, into pi. Pi we have defined 3.141 divided by 180. So this formula will convert this degree to radian. Okay, so this is the value of the input degree in terms of radian. Okay, next we observe some things. We got the value, first value of x. Okay, so what, how do we convert, find out? We see first value is x only. So we will start with x. So term will be given a value of x. So that next one will be very much easier for us, right? So term is x, and then sum also will start. So we have the first term is x only. To that x, we will add or subtract some things, right? So we have to start from x here. Please note, we are not starting from 1 or 0. This is not identity problem, okay? So here we have a series. We have different terms. So we have one thing which is already fixed, whose value we already know. So if we take, we can take 0 and then write 0 plus x also. Okay, but that will be one step extra. So anyway, because we know it is there, first step x is there, and that is value we know. Okay, so that x can be taken, x is stored into term. You can give sum equal to x or term, both are same. So we have taken the first term anyway. So if you give 0, and then you have to add one more step, sum equal to sum plus x. Okay, so that is not required. 0 plus x is anyway x only. So we will give sum equal to term. Okay, so till here, I hope it is clear. So what we did, we took input for n, number of terms, and then we took input for degree. Then we converted that degree to radian and assigned it to the variable sum and term. So that means in the problem, we have done the first part. Only the first term x is taken. Now we have to find this. So we observed some things. Okay. So the term is in the form of x power y by y factorial. Okay. What happens to y here? Y is because we have already considered. So the power is here 3 and then 5 and then 7. So that means x cube. How do we get x power 5? From that, so x cube into x will give us x to the power of 5, right? X power 5 into x, so multiply x 2 times will give us the next power, x power 7. Similarly, each So in the numerator, we observe that we have to multiply x 2 times, okay, to get the next term, right? And then what happens to denominator? We have 3 factorial. Next, we have to get 5 factorial. What is 5 factorial? We know it is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, right? So this can be written as 5 factorial is, right? Just I will display this screen, the same problem, just so that I can write it. We know 5 factorial is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Now this can also be written as 5 into 4 into what is 3 into 2 into 1? This is nothing but 3 factorial, right? So 3 factorial. So we can see that 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 can be written as 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. So next 7 factorial can be written as 7 into 6 into 5 factorial. So let us go back to this. So here we have 7 factorial is nothing but 7 into 6. Those only two numbers are missing, right? So into whatever we have in the previous term, right? So here we observe these things, right? Every time. So now anyway, we have already taken the value of x. So we will start the for loop with these terms. What is the first value of power? It is 3. Factorial also we observe is 3. Okay. So that is the first value we have to initialize. So that is the reason. Please observe the for loop. Everything becomes very important to note why we are initializing this particular thing. I is starting from 3. Because we have already taken x. Now we have to start from the second term onwards. X is already taken. So second term begins from 3, x power 3 by 3 factorial. So we will start I from 3. So we may even have declared here I equal to 3 or like that, and then leave this statement also. The for loop can be written like this. So without the initialization, if we write, see, I hope this is visible now. Okay, so this new screen is shared. You can also write the initialization outside I equal to 3. Okay, and then initialization can be omitted. For loop can be written without the initialization, without condition. There are some examples. We will discuss that later on. So it can be written like this, or let us say we take here. So as a usual, okay, equal to 3. Please note, in case we have not declared I here, I've told this. So in case we have not declared, some of you had doubt in this. So we can declare here also. If we are not using I anywhere before, okay, if we have not declared. So like we have discussed, we can declare the variable inside also. If example, we have not declared here. This can be done only for this looping variable. Okay, so we can declare I here. Right, anyway, we have declared here. Right, so here let us observe the next what happens. So I hope this new screen is visible. So we have the first term, okay, and then we know this will continue, okay, from 3, 5, 7 up to n terms. So based on whatever term we give, the values continue, okay. So based on the number of terms, so n is the number of terms. Please note, it is not this value 5, 7, 9 and all. It is the number of terms. This is 1 term, 2 terms, 3 terms, 4 terms, like that. So if we give 4, then it will stop here only. Okay. So n is where we stop. So I less than equal to n. And what happens to I? So we take 3. Next is 5. How do we get this? 3 plus 2 is 5. Next, 5 plus 2 is 7. And next 7 plus 2 is 9. So everywhere we are adding 2. So note that the loop is incremented by 2 every time. So add 2, I equal to I plus 2. Okay. So that is the updation. Updation is I equal to I plus 2. We are not seeing how it works still. We are analyzing what is written, how it should be written. Right. So this is the increment every time. Okay. So we are going to find the value of each term. Let us see. Next, when we say the term, we see, observe the term sign. First it is plus, right? Plus, if we don't have any sign, it is plus x, then we have minus, then we have plus and minus, and then plus, and it goes on alternating. So how do we get the negative sign? We multiply by a minus. So we are finding the term each time. So next term for us, we have got x. Next term is, please note, you have to take minus also into consideration. Next term is minus x cube by 3 factorial. So then whatever term we have, we will multiply minus. So next term will be plus x power 5 by 5 factorial. Okay. Next term will be minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. Then next term will be plus x power 9 by 9 factorial. Okay. So this continues. So every time we see that a minus has to be multiplied. So that is the reason we are finding the term. We are multiplying minus first. Note this minus sign. And then whatever term we have. So that term first is x. We have initialized to x. Term is x. Next, how do we find x cube from x? So x into x into x 3 times. So that is going to give x cube. So first we have one term already. Multiply 2 more. So that will give next term, x cube. When we multiply 2 more again, it will give 2 times x again. X cube into x into x, it will give x power 5. Now x power 5 into x will give x power 7. So like that, every time we see in the numerator, we are multiplying x 2 times. So that in general, we write here term into x. Okay. Next, what we have in that term is not still completed. So divided by 3 factorial. So this 3 is nothing but I, the first value. So we will see what happens next anyway. It will become 5. So we will get 5 factorial. So like that, we have to find out. How do we find this? We know that the term can be got by multiplying into its reverse. So 3 can be written as 3 into 2 into 1. If we don't multiply it 1 also, we will get 3 into 2. Okay. So let us see how this will work. So we will see with example also. That is the reason we write I into I minus 1. So don't worry about the next term now. So we will trace it. Right. So we understood that each term we are going to find. So this is 3 into 2 will give us 3 factorial. Right. We are analyzing this second term now. So 3 into 2. So I into I minus 1 means it will be 3 into 3 minus 1. 2 will give us 3 factorial. Now, this term has to be added to sum. Sum is term, that is nothing but x. Okay. So we have x here because we know already we have taken minus sign. So next term will be minus, and then this value will be added. So we found the sum. So this is about finding these two terms. So let us see. We will analyze with one example. Okay. So control C. Okay, fine. We have the Taylor series. So in Notepad, it is giving us as like this. Okay. So this is nothing but cube, x power 5, right? So we are going to have a term x here. So then we have the same term initialized to sum. Okay. So for example, we take 30. What is 30? Into pi, we will get some x value. Don't worry, we need not worry much about this right now. X value, we will get something. So 30 into pi by 180. Find out. How much is this value? Into 3.141 divided by 180 is x, that is 0.5235. Okay, so this is the value. When we convert x 30, we will get 0.52. Okay, so this is the value of x. Now that means term is also initialized with that value, right? So term is also 0.5. I'll just take rounded off value. Okay. Then sum is now also equal to term, that is also 0.5, right? So that is 0.5. right? So we have the power value here. So when we initialize term is initialized as x, so that is 0.5, which we have converted from degree to radian. Then sum is also term, that is 0.5 again. So here we have the sin x series, right? So sin x is the first term x. This is x cube by 3 factorial, x power 5. Okay, notepad, it's like this. Fine. So let us see. We'll analyze each term. What happens now? What is the first term? First term we are starting from 3. We just analyzed that. Okay, so we have the value first sum is equal to 0.5. So now when we say this, first we start I value from 3. Okay, so what happens in this step? So we have the first step I value is 3. So here when I is 3, 3 is less than equal to n. So let us say we take n as 4 terms. We will take this only, right? So let us take off this. So we will take input n. N is 4. Okay, 4 terms. So 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. So we have got n value is 4, right? So 3 is 4. Fine. We will take this value. Next, we will find the value. Let us say n is, I'm sorry, it is taking the value till 7. Okay, so this is up to the denominator. Let us say we take up to 7. Now this n is 3 7, so 3 less than equal to 7, so that is true. Fine. So now let us analyze first what happens. We have taken the first term. X is already taken as the value 0.5. It is initialized to term. Then the same value is initialized to sum. Okay. Now what happens to this term? Term, we know it is the value 0.5. Yes. Any doubts? Okay. If you have raised hand, please let me know if you have any doubt. Okay. Fine. So here we are finding the first term we found, then the next term we have to find now. Minus 3 minus x power 3 divided by 3 factorial. Okay, so that is the term. So minus term. So term value we know is minus term into x divided by I into I minus 1. So for now, we will not get confused. We will take it as x only, right? So this is nothing but x, right? So let us take as x. We will not take the decimal values because we have to compare with this term and understand this first. Okay. Let us not take 0.5. Then we will substitute for x later. Right. So let us take this as x. Fine. So term, we will take the value equal to, how do we take this? Minus term. So term is nothing but the value x. Note that I am not substituting for x now. So this 0.5 is also equal to x. We will compare that and then later we will do it. So we have term is equal to x, okay, into x. So that we are going to have these three, right? This term is also x only. So x into x into x, x power 3. I am writing x cube like this, okay, divided by what is I? I is 3. So 3 into 2. So 3 into 2, we get this value. Okay, so equal to, we will substitute for x later. Okay, so we have this term is nothing but minus x cube divided by, this is nothing but 3 into 2 is 3 factorial, right? We will not multiply and keep it. We will see how this term has to work. So this minus 3 by 3 factorial, we found the second term. This is why, because we have to find how it is going to match with the term in the series. I'm not substituting for x now. It will find the value anyway for substituting. Let us compare with the series to understand this. So we see that it is the second term minus x cube by 3 factorial. Okay. Now what is the next step? Sum equal to sum plus term. So now we have the sum is equal to, what is sum? Sum is initialized as term. Term is x. Let us stop here because it will take 0.5. We will not take that step now. So we will substitute for x later. So sum is right now x plus term. What is this term? So even if we have plus also, if there is a minus sign, it will take it as it is. We know this, right? So term is this value. Okay. So we have written that in general now. So sum is x minus x cube by 3 factorial. So note that we got this step. I am still doing it in general. Later we will substitute for x as 0.5. Okay. So let us find the second next term now. Now what is the value? We have x. So this I becomes I plus 2. So next step I plus 2. Second step I plus 2. That is 3 plus 2. I becomes 5. Right. So 5 is also less than equal to 7. N is the last value we take. So that we have taken here as 7 less than equal to 7. Now what should happen to term? So term is equal to what is the term previously minus? So minus we have, okay, minus into whatever term we have. So what was the term before? So term we will take previously we found this. Control C. It will calculate, but we are going to substitute as it is. Okay. Later we will substitute for x. So this much. Okay. That is the minus sign. And then we are taking term as it is. We are doing this in general first. Okay. Next, what should we do? We have taken previous term and then multiply x 2 times into x into x. So that is the value. Okay. So divided by I. What is I now? I value is 5. Okay. So 5 into 4. Okay. Now this is what we have seen. Right. Now when we do this, we see that there is numerator by denominator format in both the places. So let us first concentrate on the numerator part. What is this? Minus into minus, it becomes plus. So that is plus. Okay. And then we have only the numerator. Please note the numerator here is x cube into x is the numerator. So that is x cube into x becomes x power 5. Okay. Divided by. We have 3 factorial here in the denominator already. 3 factorial into 5 into 4 becomes what? 5 into 4, okay, into 3 factorial, right? So this is nothing but x power 5. So plus, if we don't write, also fine, x power 5 divided by 5 into 4 into 3 factorial is nothing but 5. Factorial. Okay. I hope the term is clear. So I will repeat this. So here x I value in the second step is 5. 5 less than equal to 7. Yes, this condition is true. And then next we have the term. So term is minus. We have to multiply minus and into the previous term. Previous term we know is minus x cube by 3 factorial. And then into x. So we are multiplying x 2 times divided by I into I minus 1. So that is 5 into 5 minus 1, 4. Okay. So this is a term by substituting the previous value. Now, when we find this, we have to simplify this further. So minus into minus is plus. Okay. And then x cube into x is x power 5. That is the numerator. So numerator is x power 5. Next, we have to find the denominator. Denominator, we have 2 denominators, multiply them. So 3 factorial is the denominator here into 5 into 4. So that gives us 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. Okay. So this is a little simplified. Let us simplify further. So plus if we is same as without the operator also unsigned is plus itself. So we write x power 5. Divided by 5 into 4 into 3 factorial is 5 factorial. Okay. So the second term we found in the second step, the second term is x power 5 by 5 factorial. Okay. It will substitute for x and find out. Right. So we have compared it with the Taylor series. So we observe it is x to the power of 5 by 5 factorial is the next term. Okay. Now what should happen? This has to be added to the value of sum. So whatever was the previous sum, okay, plus this new term has to be added. So what do we get here for sum? So sum is nothing but previous sum. Please note, I am doing it in general. Later, x value can be substituted so that we can compare and understand. Okay, so we have the sum here. So previous sum, that is what will be taken. Okay, so whatever was the previous sum plus term. What is the term we have? So plus term. Term is x power 5 by 5 factorial. So now our sum is this much, right? X cube, okay, x power 5 by 5 factorial. So we see that the sum is x minus x cube by 3 factorial plus x power 5 by 5 factorial. When you observe the Taylor series, we got the first three terms. So we have one more step remaining. So let us do that. That is the next step. So what happens in the loop here? We are finding the value. So I equal to I plus 1. So the third step we will have, which is I equal to I plus 2. That is I will be 5 plus 2. That is 7. Okay. So 7 less than equal to 7. Yes, 7 is equal to 7. So condition is true. Okay. So in this case, now find the term. So what is the term? Term will be equal to, first we have minus. Do not forget this. Okay. Very important. We are going to have a minus. Okay. Multiplied by, then we have term. Whatever was the previous term. What is the previous term? So x power 5 into divided by 5 factorial. X power 5 divided by 5 factorial is our term. So that has to be multiplied by x into x. Okay. So term we are multiplying into x into x. So this is our numerator divided by what is I? So I is 7. So 7 into I minus 1. 7 minus 1 is 6. Okay. So we substituted for the value of I and term. Now let us simplify this further like we did for the previous step. So first we have the sign. So minus. So that will be taken. Minus. And then what is there in the numerator? We have x power 5. And then we have into x into x. X power 5 into x will give us x power 7. Okay. X power 5 into x. X power 6 into x will give x power 7. That is the numerator. Divided by, what is denominator? 5 factorial into 7 into 6. So I will just rearrange. So that will be nothing but 7 into 6 into 5 factorial. So this is our denominator and this closing bracket for this, okay, bracket. So now we have this term like this. So let us simplify further. So minus, we have the numerator x power 7, okay, divided by 7 into 6 into 5 factorial is nothing but 7 factorial, right? So that will give us 7 factorial. So what is this? This is our value of term. I will just add a bracket. Okay. I hope this part is clear. So we calculated the next term. Please keep observing things. Match it with the question. Taylor series, we calculated the next term. So we got this much in sum. Now this has to be added. The next term has to be added to sum. Okay, we have the sign also minus term. Okay, so next what happens? We are finding the value of sum. Okay, so sum is equal to sum plus term. What is sum? So whatever we found previously. So this is the sum. Okay, so that we will take here. If you are getting confused, we'll just add brackets to this. So sum x minus, just adding brackets. It is the same value. So that is the sum. This entire thing is sum. Okay. This entire thing is this sum. Previous sum. Plus we have to add the term. Okay. How do we do that? We'll have plus and then have this term. What is our term? Minus x power 7 by 7 factorial is the term. Okay. This bracket I have added because we have plus and minus. That is same as this term itself. So plus into minus will give us minus like we did in the first step. So let us simplify this further. I will remove all the brackets. Okay. X minus. So we have this same, right? X cube by 3 factorial Okay, then we have plus the next term x power 5 divided by 5 factorial. Now note plus into minus is minus. So next we will have minus x power 7 divided by 7 factorial. So this is our sum. Is this same as the Taylor series? X minus x cube by 3 factorial plus x power 5 by 5 factorial minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. So this is our sum. Okay, so this is sum. Fine. So we got the value of sum now. What happens next? We have the fourth step. Say we have taking next I equal to I plus 2, right? So I plus 2, I becomes 7 plus 2, 9. Okay, 9 is the value of I. I equal to 9. Now compare that with the condition. 9 is it less than equal to n? N is 7. 9 less than equal to 7? No. Condition false. 9 is neither less than 7 nor equal. So condition becomes false. The control will exit from the loop. So because the condition is false, control exits from the loop. Then it goes to the next statement. Print sign of percentage f. Percentage f in terms of degree only we will print. Sine 30 equal to sum. So how do we get this? Just substitute for value of sum. Okay, so we have the variable here, the expression control sum. Now if we substitute, how do we find this value? So that is nothing but equal to x is 0.5. okay, so you can just find out what is this value. 0.5. Just substitute 0.5 to the power of 5, 3 divided by 3 factorial. This is one term, okay, x cube by 3 factorial. Then similarly, we have plus. So next term is x power 5, right? I've just taken the same term, x power 5, 0.5 power 5 by 5 factorial. Okay, minus x is 0.5, 0.5 power 7 by 7 factorial. Just simplify this, whatever you get is the answer. So it will print that is nothing but sum. Okay, so sine 30 will be whatever value we get here. So evaluate this, substitute and evaluate, we will get the value of sum. Okay, so that is nothing but sine series, Taylor series sine value. Is this clear? Okay. Any doubts? Yes, students, any doubts in this?
No.
No? Please note that next you take x power 9. Okay, also take n as 9 and then find out. You take one more step. We have done four steps here. So you take one more step and analyze it. So then you can understand. So here, just take 9, then you will compare every time with 9. So, do you want any step to be repeated? Okay. I will just see. In short, let me explain again. Right? So, here we have the value. First, we are taking the value sine series. We analyze that sine series is x minus x cube minus x power 5 minus x power 7 and so on. It continues till value of n. So we declared the required variables. Okay. And then we are seeing the value input n. N will be 7. That means we want to stop the series at x power 7. Okay. Then we have the input degree. So say 30. So 30 has to be taken in terms of degree. Convert it to radians. So convert radians, that becomes 30 into pi. Pi we have defined using hash define, which is a constant. Pi is 3.141. Okay, divided by 180. We get the value of x in radians, 0.5235. Now this x is an initialized to term because we know in the series the first term is x only. So we have taken that as x. The same value is taken for sum. Okay. So please note, you have to analyze it step by step. Again, you take different values also and analyze. Okay. So we have taken series, we have taken in this example till 7. You can take one more step, also give 9, then it will be minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. Then next term will be plus x power 9 by 9 factorial. Okay, so till there you can do one more step, add one step to this. So we have taken series till 7. So let us evaluate this. We have to find the value of sine x. So first term we know is x. We have initialized that to term and sum. So because second term will start from 3, we see that it is odd number. 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on is odd number. So we are starting from 3 and we have to stop here according to our example at n. So n is 7. So I less than equal to 7 will be the condition. Okay, and when we observe one more thing, how does it get incremented? 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 2, 7. Every time we are adding 2. So I is equal to I plus 2 is the operation. So first we have taken the term, right? So this is the initialization. First term is 3. Then up to n value is considered 7 here in this case. And every time updation is adding 2 to the value of x, I. So that is x cube, x power 5 and so on. 3, 5, 7, 9. So we are adding 2. Now we will find each term separately. So first term is already taken, x value we have taken for term and sum. Next term, we see that the sum, the sign is alternating. So minus plus minus. So we are taking a sign minus into whatever we have the term. So that next term will be minus into minus plus. So every time we multiply by minus, the sign will alternate. That is the reason we take minus here. Then minus into whatever is the previous term. Okay, so previous term is x. We have to multiply by x into x. So x cube, okay, we get by multiplying x into x into x. So when we multiply previous term two times by x, we will get next term. So x cube into x will give x power 5. Similarly, into x will give x power 7. So we have previous term into x, we will get the numerator of the next term. Okay, so then what about denominator? This x is nothing but x power 1 by 1 factorial. So when we multiply into 3 into 2, we will get the next denominator 3 factorial. Okay, 3 factorial into next two numbers, we will get 5 factorial. We have to observe like this so that we have 3. Okay, so 3 into 2. So 3 into I minus 1, I into I minus 1, 3 into 2. So that is what we have in the first step. So let us see. So we have taken I equal to 3, first step. 3 is less than equal to 7, true. So term will be minus, so that term is x and then x into x. So that becomes x cube. Okay, previous term x into x, x cube divided by 3, I value is 3, I minus 1 is 2. So 3 into 2. Now we have that is nothing but simplify minus x cube by 3 factorial. So we got the next term. Okay, now this has to be added to the previous value, sum. Sum is x, as we know, that is the first term is x. So that is the value. To that, we have to add the second term. So we have sum is already x, okay? Sum plus term. Term is what we find here. So term is minus x cube by 3 factorial. Add that to sum. So we get x minus x power 3 by 3 factorial. We got the first two terms. Next step, I becomes 5. 5 is less than equal to 7. Condition is true. Now find the next term. What is the next term? X power 5. We have to find that. So term is minus. Well, previous term is minus x cube into 3 factorial. Please note, we are alternating the sign. Minus into minus becomes plus. So that is why we are now know we have multiplied minus. Minus into minus will become plus. So that is previous term x power 3 by 3 factorial. Then what is multiplied? Into x is multiplied here, divided by I is 5 into I minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4. So 5 into 4, that is the next term. We will simplify this. So when we observe, we have minus into minus becomes plus, and then x cube we have, and then in the numerator we also have into x into x. X cube into x will give x power 5. Divided by, we have denominator 3 factorial and 5 into 4. So multiply all of them. So 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. So that is nothing but 5 factorial. Okay. So we got the third term, which is plus x power 5 by 5 factorial. So this has to be added to sum. So this thing, the first two terms are there in sum. Okay. So that, to that we will add the next term which we found in this step. So this term has added to the sum. So we will get this sum as x minus x cubed by 3 factorial plus x power 5 by 5 factorial. When we compare it to the series, it is the first three terms. Okay. So it will substitute for the value of x also. Now let us see what happens next step. I is I plus 2. 5 plus 2, I becomes 7. Okay. Compare. 7, is it less than equal to 7? Yes, true. Now find the term. So when we find the next term, we have minus. Okay. So as it is, into term. What is previous term? Previous term is x power 5 by 5 factorial. So that is taken, substitute for the term. Okay. And then into x is the numerator, divided by I is 7 into 7 minus 1, 6. So divided by 7 into 6. So this is our next term. Okay. Let us simplify. So minus is as it is. When we see the numerator, x power 5 into x, we will get x power 7. Denominator, 5 factorial into 7 into 6, we write it as, so just reorder, 7 into 6 into 5 factorial. Okay, we can further simplify this. So this becomes minus, numerator is x power 7. So 7 into 6 into 5 factorial can be written as 7 factorial. So we got the next term, minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. So that is the next term. We have to add it to the sum. That is sum equal to sum plus term. So sum will be equal to previous sum. What is the previous sum? This much, right? So that is our previous sum. With brackets it is written, right? So that is our previous sum plus. What is next sum we found? Term. Term is minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. So when we just remove the brackets, we get sum is x minus x cubed by 3 factorial plus x power 5 by 5 factorial minus x power 7 by 7 factorial. So next, in the next step, we are adding 2. 7 plus 2, we get I equal to 9. 9 less than equal to 7? No, condition is false. The control exits from the loop. So we have found the value of the series is in the variable sum, right? So print the value. Sine of percentage f is nothing but degree. So sine 30 equal to this percentage f is sum. So substitute for x. So whatever value we have, the expression, substitute for x and simplify, that value we will get. So that is the value of sum. So it gets printed. Please execute this. Okay. So and then let me know if you have any doubt. Is this clear? You are all unmuted. Please let me know. Is this clear?
Yes,
students. Is this clear? So we discussed the Taylor series. Yes? Okay. Yes. Okay. Fine. So here we have seen how to find sine of x. You can take any value for x. If you take say 30, 50, 45, whatever value you want, you can take, and then you can find out what is the value of sine x, right? So then just substitute for x and find out the value. So that is the value of Taylor series. So let's go back to this. The new screen is displayed here, which is the solution. Okay, so here just find value of x and then substitute and print it. Okay, so next we have one exercise problem. I hope you have just read this problem. When we see this, asked you to read the question, right? So here we observe that the exercise says we have write a program to find the sum of all even numbers from 1 to n, where the value of n is taken as input. So that means, example, when n is 10, so till n, what are the even 10? What are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So we have to add these numbers. So add all the even numbers till 10. So first we have to find what are the even numbers till n, and then we have to add them. Okay. So 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10. Answer output should be 30. So when we see this, always analyze a question. First we have to see what is the input and then what is the output. What is input? Input is 10. The value of n is the input. What is output? Output is 30. Okay. So sum of even numbers. What is the logic? So first step, always find what is input, what is output. Then second step, find what is the logic to find the output. Okay. So logic is 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 will give 30. So this is the logic. So now how to solve for this? So we have to find the even numbers first. So we are starting from 1. We know 1 is an odd number, but still we will start from 1 and find out each number. Okay. Since the series has to start from 1 to n. So n is the value to be taken as input. Let us see. So because we are adding here, what should be initialized for sum? Anyone? What is initialized for sum? What is the initial value? Zero. Why?
Additive identity.
Very good. So zero is additive identity. Why we need to take additive identity? Because we are adding all the terms. So additive identity. Sum is taken as additive identity. Zero. Okay. So here we have taken the initial value of sum as zero. Okay. So then take value of n. You can add one printf statement if you want. Add, enter the value of n here. Okay. So here it will take the value of n. So here assume we get the value taken as 10. So what happens? N is 10. Then declare a variable I is the index. So I starts from 1. Okay. So for I equal to 1, I less than equal to n. So up to n we have to solve. N is 10. And everywhere we are checking each number. Okay. So even though this sum seems like plus 2, don't give like that. We have to check each number. We cannot simply write plus 2. Okay. So we have to check for odd or even. That is mentioned. Fine. So we have to give I plus plus. Now how to check for odd or even? We know that I percentage 2 equal to 0. If the remainder when divided by 2 is 0, it is even. Okay. So here we are not printing odd or even. If it is even, we have to add that number, right? So in this case, so let me see this. I'm just taking this. So I've just taken the same here. So you can see the program, new screen, which is the program in this case, so that we have started from n. We know that n value is taken as input here. So let here n value equal to 10. Okay. So now we are taking this. We need to find the series. What is the series to be found? 2 plus 4 even numbers, 6, right? Plus 8 up to 10, right? So that we have seen as example. So this is what we have to solve. Right. So we need to find the numbers, even numbers. So here we have taken I equal to 1. So it has to be checked. So first up from I equal to 1, we are checking. That is the first step. Right. So I less than equal to n. 1 less than equal to 10. Yes, this is true. But when we check here, 1 percentage 2, when we divide 1 by 2, remainder is 1. So we don't have to execute this part if condition is false. So this will not be found. So sum is 0 only. Okay. Now it will go back. What happens to I next? I equal to 2. 2 less than equal to 10. Condition is true, right? So 2 is less than 10. Condition true. What happens here? So when we say, we check the value. Is 2% 2 0? 2 when we divide by 2? Yes, it is divisible. We get the remainder as 0. So what happens to sum? So sum will be equal to, what is sum? We have initialized to zero. Otherwise, it will take some random garbage value and add that value. Okay, so this is sum. Okay, so here we have the value sum is zero plus what is I? I is 2, right? So I value is 2. So now sum will be 2. Okay, so we found the value of sum. Sum is currently equal to 2. Now again, loop back. I becomes 3. Right? So when we say 3, 3 is less than equal to n, s. 3% 2, is it equal to 0? No, it gives 1 as a reminder. So no addition. This step will not execute because the condition is false. So this step will not execute. It will go back. Now I becomes 4. So what happens? For I equal to 3, condition is false. Right? So next, we have 4. What happens when I equal to 4? 4 less than if condition is false. Okay, so here this condition is true, but if is false. So there is no updation for sum. When I is 4, so 4% 2. 4 when you divide by 2, it is 0. So we have the previous sum. For 4, when we say condition of if is true, so sum will be updated. What was the previous sum? Sum is 2 plus I. Okay, 2 plus I is 4. Okay, so 2 plus 4. So sum we will get as 6. Then later when we say I becomes 5, condition false. Okay, I becomes 6. This condition is true. This will continue till 10, right? I less than equal to 10 is the condition. 6 less than 10, true. Now whatever we have is sum. Sum is 6. Okay, 2 plus 4 plus 6 will be added. So 6 plus 6, we will get 12. We got the first 3. Now for 7, condition is false. So if condition is not done, when it becomes 8, we'll get 12. We have the previous sum plus 8. We will get the next sum, that is 20. Okay. Now when I becomes 9, okay, 9 less than equal to 10, this condition for condition is true. And then when we check if 9% 2 equal to 1, so this is false. So this step will not execute. Next, I becomes 10. What happens? 10 less than equal to 10. Yes, 10 is equal to 10. True. Then when we check 10% 2, reminder is 0. Okay. So sum will be previous sum. That is, previous sum was 20 plus what is I? I is 10. So we get sum as 30. Next, I becomes 11. 11, when we check 11, is it less than equal to 10? Condition is false. So it comes out of the loop. Okay. What is sum? Sum is 30. Just print that sum. I hope this is clear. So 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 equal to 8 plus 10 equal to 30. Okay. So that is the exercise. So please analyze this way. So each step, you can take one more value of 10, give instead of 10, give 15 and solve for this. Okay. So solve for the Taylor series and this also. Exercise. We just discussed this. Okay, a simple one. I hope this is clear. Do you all understand this exercise problem? Yes, dear students, is this exercise problem clear? Okay, there is one doubt. In C++, you say you are using clear screen to remove. No, that clear screen is only used to clear the screen, as the name says. Okay, so it is only for clearing the output screen, right? In C, we just use the value clear, right? Just that will clear the output screen only, right? So in this, we do not remove the garbage values using clear. Okay, that value will be taken as it is. So the clear screen is not used here. That is used only in Turbo C++. So we are not using that in this programming. Fine. Any other doubt? You can message or even you can unmute yourself also and ask if you have doubt. Okay, as I've told you before. I hope this exercise problem is clear. Geeta? Is this clear? Geeta is here. Please respond when you are asked. Okay, clear? Fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So now we have seen this exercise. Next exercise is also pretty simple. If you just see, it is a sum of series. So let us analyze. First, always you have to see what is input and then what is the output, the first step. So write a C program to find sum of series where the value of n is taken as input. So n is the input. What is the series? Series is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 up to 1 by n. So this is the series. We have to find the value. So here each term is the first term divided 1 by 1. Okay, 1 can be written as 1 by 1. Next is 1 by 2. So I value, if you see, it keeps on incrementing. So updation will be I plus plus, right? So that is one thing we can recognize. So it, I starts from 1. I equal to 1 will be initialization and updation will be I plus plus. What is condition? I has to move up to n. I less than equal to n. Okay, so that is the condition. So now we have taken one variable n and then sum we have initialized 0.0 because it is float. Okay, and then you can give one printf, enter the value of n. Okay, then take input scanf. Okay, n, read n from the test case so that you can take any value. So if we take 5, then it will take till 5. This much will be calculated. So I starts from 1 up to 5. Okay, so here every time, so sum is 0 first. So 1 by, why do we give float? Anyone? Why do we give float here?
Decimal values.
Yes, because it is decimal. If we give 1 by I, what happens? What happens if we give 1 by I?
It will get converted to integer values.
Yes, that is true. Integer value, this there will be problem of typecasting, right? So we discussed example of typecasting. So that is the reason we are applying explicit typecasting. We have discussed problems like this before also. So 1 by float of I, we are doing explicit typecasting so that answer does not become 0 or some other integer. We want the decimal values. We want floating point values for finding the sum. Otherwise, 1 by 1, 1 by 2 will be 0.5. It will take it as 0. Then this is 1 by 3, again, some other value, say 0. Something. It will again take that as 0. 1 by 4 will be 0.25. Again, it is taken as 0. So instead of finding values, this series will become 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0, which we don't want, right? So that is the reason take float. Okay, so that is the reason we take 1 by float of I. Everywhere we are having I in the denominator. So 1 by I has to be written. If we write only 1 by I, it will convert it to integer because 1 is also integer, I is also integer. So mention float of I. So every time find out 1 by 1 plus 2, add that. Then 1 plus 3, it gets added. So we will get the sum up to n. So if we take n as 5, it will add each and then find the sum. The tracing of this is your homework. Okay? Can you do this? Tracing for this problem? Dear students, can you trace for this problem?
Yes.
Yes, try it. Okay, take n as 5. You can take till 5 and then trace. Okay, like we did exactly for the previous problem, trace that and see how it, you are going to get the value of sum. So then we are printing 0.2f. What is this 0.2f? Anyone can answer?
After decimal point, two places.
Okay, good. After decimal point, we have two numbers to be printed. Okay, so that is point 2F. Okay, so please trace for this problem like exactly how we did for previous one, and then analyze. If you get any doubt, please let me know. Okay. Till today we have seen three problems. Okay, any doubts in any of that problem? Are these problems clear? Tarun, you have some doubt?
No, ma'am.
Now you have some message, something? Double, what is that? Double data type?
Oh, yeah.
What? Your doubt is not clear. Okay. You were telling about this two numbers. Is it? Okay, fine. Yeah, 0.2 means after decimal point, you will get two numbers. So that is 0.2F. Okay. So all of you, please message your name and roll number. And note that attending all the classes is compulsory. Okay, you have to attend, and I have messaged in the group also. In case there is any issue, please mail it officially to me with stating the reason. So please inform your friends. Today's strength is again 35. Okay. All of you message your name and roll number. And if you have any doubts in the problems discussed today, please let me know. So today we discussed, just to sum up, so previous class we just saw reverse and then comparing reverse of a number. So today we discussed how to find the value of Taylor series sine x value. Okay, and then that is each term we have to find out separately and add them. Okay, we saw with example test this case, and that is tracing also, right? So convert that value from degrees to radians. So here, this problem we just discussed, the new screen shows the problem here. So we discussed that taking input, sorry. The problem. So here we have taken n value, input as 7, and then degree in terms of 30. Say then we converted that. We just discussed this problem, finding out the value of sine x. Right? So then we see the next problem. We took a value of 30 there, then find sine x, and then print add term every in each step, that is alternate sign, add that to sum. So we found the value of sine. The next problem we discussed was sum of series wherein each term is an even number. Okay, each term is an even number. We found check start from 1 up to n, and then calculate sum by finding, checking if it is even number. And then the next sum program, we saw sum of series by of 1 plus 1 by 2 up to 1 by n, how to find the sum. So we have traced this previous sum also. Similarly, you trace for this problem. Okay. I hope this is clear. Yes. Are these problems clear? Did you all understand these problems?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Thank you.